Captive chimpanzees understand English as well as a human 2-year-old, and use signs from human sign languages. Dolphins jointly coordinate their actions to open containers and perform novel tricks. A parrot can reliably report the number and color of an item, and prairie dogs sound the alarm that a tall human wearing white is approaching fast. Do animals use language? And if so, can we use AI to talk with them? Humans use language to communicate. Animals also communicate, both visually and verbally, on a variety of topics, from where to find food to a desire to mate or warnings of danger. But human language is more than mere communication. Human language productively combines a discrete inventory of mostly arbitrary units of sound, each with individual fixed meanings, to jointly convey novel information. Language can describe things immediately present, remote in time or space, or even hypothetical, and sophisticated rules govern the manner in which we combine these units. Words come in categories: nouns, verbs, prepositions. Some categories, such as verbs, demand that other words fill subservient semantic roles. The verb give requires several arguments: a giver, a thing given, and a recipient. You cannot say, "Sarah gave John," without the hearer asking, "What did Sarah give?" But perhaps the most distinctive aspect of human language is its use of recursive structure to encode meaning. In "The Girl That Saw the Man That Drove the Truck That Blew a Tire Left Already," each "that" introduces a recursive clause that contributes to the meaning of the full sentence. AI Talks covers humanity's attempts to teach artificial systems to communicate using language. Understanding the subtle differences and surprising similarities between human languages and animal communication systems can help us zero in on what exactly an artificial language system needs to accomplish. At first glance, most animal communication might seem simplistic compared to human language. But actually, various animals tick the boxes for nearly all the properties of language. Many animals have a repertoire of discrete vocalizations that carry fixed meanings. For example, a low-ranking rhesus monkey will make a noisy scream sound when confronted by a higher-ranking member of the social group, while the higher-ranking member will make arched screams, a separate, distinct sound. Many songbirds have a high-pitched, pure-toned seet call that warns of an approaching predator, and a separate, harsher mobbing call that marshals nearby birds to swarm a predator. Animals can communicate about events not immediately present. Bees dance to tell other members of their hive where to find food some distance away. Prairie dog alarm calls have been shown to encode the information that a human is approaching who shot a gun sometime in the past. And captive dolphins, who've been taught separate commands to perform a novel acrobatic trick and to perform a trick with another dolphin, when asked to perform a novel trick together, somehow coordinate their future actions to do so. The physical form of some signals that animals produce definitely influences the meaning of that signal. For example, the warning seet of songbirds may be high and pure-toned because it is more difficult to locate the source of high-pitched sounds. But many signals that animals use to communicate have an arbitrary meaning. Slobodchikoff has shown that prairie dogs encode significant amounts of information by modulating the frequencies of their short, chirping alarm calls in specific but arbitrary ways. Some animals, such as Slobodchikoff's prairie dogs, seem capable of productively describing novel ideas. In one experiment, Slobodchikoff used a clothesline pulley system to send life-sized plywood cutouts into the middle of a prairie dog colony. One cutout was of a coyote's silhouette, while another was an abstract oval shape of about the same size. Each silhouette elicited distinct calls from the prairie dogs. The coyote cutout received calls similar to those the prairie dogs used for real coyotes, but in response to the oval shape, the prairie dogs produced an entirely novel call. Similarly, when a young captive chimpanzee named Washu did not know the sign for her potty chair, she productively combined a novel sequence of signs she did know. Dirty and good. Going even further into the realm of human language, chimps and also dolphins have been shown to understand at least a limited form of semantic argument structure. A captive chimpanzee named Allie understood prepositional phrases like toothbrush on blanket, which require two arguments, an item and a location for that item. In formal tests of his understanding, Allie would place the correct item on the correct target up to 60% of the time. Despite a hyperactive chimp personality that often led him to lose interest before completing tasks. In another set of experiments, researchers also taught prepositional phrases to two captive dolphins, Ake and Phoenix, using two very different command structures. Ake learned a gesture-based language, while Phoenix was given verbal commands. Meanwhile, just as different human languages use different word orders, Phoenix was given commands in the form Object A on Object B, while Ake's instructions came as Object A, Object B on. Of all the proposed properties of human language, the only one that has not been conclusively documented in animal communication systems is recursive structure. And even here, there is ongoing debate on whether some songbirds combine calls with different meanings using recursive syntax. So, with their many parallels to human languages, do animal communication systems qualify as full-fledged language? Some scientists, including Slobodchikoff, call animal communication animal language exactly because, just as humans use language to communicate, animals' verbal and gestural signals are the way in which animals communicate. If human language evolved from the communication systems of our distant ancestors, then shouldn't animal communication also qualify as language? If we systematically separate human language from animal communication, we risk placing a barrier between us lofty humans and the natural world we're a part of. After all, animals' communication systems serve them and their environment just as human language serves us and ours. It seems terribly unfair to banish animals from the language club just because they might not communicate in the same way we do. But both animals and humans use communication systems that are clearly not language. Road signs communicate information using non-arbitrary symbols that indicate aspects of the immediate environment, but that very rarely can be combined in any intelligible way. Animals also mark territory and paths without resorting to language. Humans and animals both use physical appearance to signal age, gender, and social status, but our fashion statements do not follow the grammatical rules of natural language. Still, while there is currently no overwhelming evidence of any animal communication system that exhibits all the features of human language, this does not guarantee that we might not yet discover one that does, which is why I'm so excited about current projects that use techniques from AI and machine learning to analyze and decipher the vocalizations of some of the most intelligent and largest-brained non-human species on the planet. Whales. Project SETI, C-E-T-I, led by Michael Bronstein from the Imperial College London, is analyzing the bursts of clicks sperm whales use to communicate over long distances. While another group, led by Denise Herzing, research director of the Wild Dolphin Project, and Thad Stammer of Georgia Tech, is analyzing the sounds produced by dolphins. The techniques that both groups use come directly from modern natural language processing. Specifically, they use deep neural networks to build language models of animal vocalizations. A language model is a computational system that, given the first few items of a sequence, predicts what will come next. While 10 years ago, the best language models were unable to generate even a single coherent sentence, now deep language models like GPT-3 can generate entire paragraphs that largely hang together. There are many challenges that must be overcome to apply deep language models to whale vocalizations. How to find the whale's equivalent of a word, how to scale up the number of recorded whale vocalizations. Current successful deep learning algorithms were trained on orders of magnitude more data than the number of sperm whale recordings we currently have. But perhaps the largest challenge will be that even if we are able to build a language model over whale vocalizations, the model might produce output that, while sounding natural and correct to a sperm whale, to us humans, is just another unintelligible series of clicks. A recent paper by Emily Bender and Alexander Kohler argues that modern language models like GPT-3 that are trained solely on text are inherently unable to connect the words they produce to objects and entities in the real world. These models do not understand either the input or the output text. They simply produce sequences of the clicks that humans are able to interpret. Personally, I hope these challenges can be overcome, that we discover whales really do communicate in full-fledged language, that whales who already clearly manipulate and exploit their environment communicate meaning by combining arbitrary symbols in complex, even recursive ways. I hope we discover not only the proper response to a whale's vocalization, but an interpretation of that vocalization in language that humans understand. I, for one, look forward to the day we have a meaningful conversation with whales. When AI talks. With this episode, I'm trying something new. I'm releasing the same content that's in this video as a written blog. Follow the link in the description below.